Last time we had seen Anando Brahmeti Vyajanat in the statement of Bhruvavalli that Ananda refers to Brahmananda only, Paramananda only, and not simply Ananta, which is not Ananda. We had seen Ananda, happiness, by itself need not necessarily be Ananta, limitless. Sense pleasures, Vishesukhas, are not limited, limitless. They are limited in nature. But when the word Ananda is used along with the Brahma, Brahma being Ananta, Ananda also becomes Ananta. And it doesn't mean that Ananda is Ananta and that Ananta is not Ananda, you can't say. If you say so, you have forgotten Chandogya Upanishad. Chandogya says, Yo vai bhuma tat sukham. Whatever that is bhuma. Bhuma means analpam. Na alpam. No, not limited. Anything, the entity that is limitless, bhuma, is sukham, ananda. Alpe sukha na sukham nasi. In anything that is limited, there is no happiness at all. So therefore, to say that ananda is not ananda, you jump to the word ananta, you are landed where? Where you are landed? In Paramananda, Brahmananda only. Why? Because Ananta, Ananta can be only Brahma. If you say something Ananta, limitless, other than Brahma is there, Brahma will get limited and is no more Brahma. So anything that is limitless Ananta has to be Brahma, and that is what is Ananda. Other we have seen Vidnyanam Ananda Brahma. We have seen the Gunopasamhara based on the Brahma Sutra, etc. So therefore, the moment you say Ananda, it is not necessarily Paramananda, Brahmananda only. So Ananda, if Vishyananda, sense pleasure is limited. That is not the context that we call Anando Brahmeti Vajami. One more some notion that is floating around. Moksha is not freedom from Janma Marana. You understood? Moksha is not to get freed from Janma and Marana. That means these votaries of this notion, they opt for Janma Marana also. And simultaneously, moksha. Keeping the body, they speak of moksha. You tell me, is it possible or not? Simply yes, no will not work.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, tell me why. Oh. Body is there and yet moksha is there. That means you don't know what is moksha. In moksha, sorrow is there? Sure. Not even trace of it. Not only not even trace of it, there is no possibility of it. There is no possibility. Fine? And if Janma Varna is there, body is there or not?
Yes.
When body is there, possibility of sorrow is there or not?
Yes.
If you say no, I will refer you to Bhagavan Krishna. Dukkha Sayoga. Yoga is Vyoga, separation from what? Dukkha Sayoga. What is Dukkha Sayoga? Pin attached to what? Gross body, subtle body, causal body. Even Jivan Mukta, who has got knowledge and everything, if he is aware of the body, Drishta Dukkha is there. Because of his knowledge, he knows it is Badhita, Mithya he knows. But that experience you cannot deny. So you keep the sarira there and then speak about moksha is something which is no, that means not, which is not Shastra told. Let us see now what Bhagavad Gita has to say. Chapter 251. Janma Vanda Vinirmuktaha Padam Gacchantyanavayam. Jnani, from God, that means what? Anavayam Padam Gacchanti. Nirupadravam Padam Gacchanti. Brahma Swarupad again. And what is that? Janma Vanda Vinirmuktaha. What does it mean? Result of moksha is freedom from Janma Varna Samsara. What in English you call as transmigration. Not simply migration, okay? Migration from a country to country. No, transmigration. That is what they say. Means freedom from Janma. No, transmigration is Janma Varna. Your freedom from Varna. That's fine. 8th chapter, 15th verse, all Bhagavad Gita only. Mamu petya punar janma. Dukkhalaya mashashvatam natnuvanti mahatmanaha samsiddhim paramangataha. Maam upetya, whom Bhagavan says, having gained me Brahma Swarupa, who are they? These mahatmanaha, jnaninaha, Brahma jnaninaha. Dukkhalayam ashashvatam punarjanma na apnuvanti. They don't take to punarjanma. And do you know what is punarjanma? Any janma? Dukkhalayam ashashvatam. What is dukkhalaya? Storehouse of? You know? What is that? Arogyalaya. Hospital. Bhojanalaya. What else? What else? Chikitsalaya. Chikitsalaya. Treatment. Dukkhalaya. Nothing but concentrated sorrow. And ashashvatam. No guarantee of this. So that is what they don't get it. May freedom from Janma Varna or not. And who says? Krishna says, having got moksha. And that is what. They are nine, this. 8th chapter 16. Maam upetya kaunteya punarjanmana vidyate. Having gained me, having given moksha, there is no rebirth. 9th chapter 3rd verse. Ashraddha dhanaha purushaha dharmasyasya parantapa apraapya maam nivartante mrutya samsara vartmani. Those who have no shraddha in this Atmajnana, Brahmajnana that I unfolded so far, without gaining me, they return. Where? Samsara vartmani. Mrutya samsara vartmani. Samsara character and the mrutya, the highest sorrow. The peak of sorrow in samsara is what? Mrutya. For the dying one and the surviving one. For then, 9th chapter, 33rd verse. Anitya masukam lokam imam prapya bhajasvama. Having come here, which loka? Anityam masukam. We have seen this. Nameplate for the jagat by given by who? Bhagavan himself. Bhagavan himself. The jagat is what? Number one, anitya. And we expect what? Nitya. Asukam. No sukha. And we expect what? Bhagavan will say, what can I do for you? I have told, no suffer. I am there to help you, provided you seek. Okay. You seek the help. So that person says, anitya masukam lokam. Anitya masukam lokam imam prasya bhajasvama. You have come, you have landed in this, now better what? Seek me, seek me. There is no other hope for you. Tesha Mahamsa Mundharta, 12th chapter, 7th verse. Tesha Mahamsa Mundharta, Vrutya Samsara Sagara. those yogis who meditate on me, as how ananya. What is ananya? There is nothing other than me, Paramatma only. So they, whatever, I just free them from this samsara sagara. Thirteenth chapter, 8th verse. Janma mrutya jara vyadi dukkha doshanu darshanam. One of the values. See the defects of what? Dukkha in janma mrutya jara vyadi. And you would like to have an expression. At least this much you know, in moksha, no sorrow. And body is there, means what? Janma mrutya, sorrow only. I mean, can be no moksha. Further, 13th chapter, 25th verse. Tepi chati taranteva mrutyam shruti parayanaha. Shruti parayanaha. It is there. First, those who are yogis gain me. Those who take to atmavichara successfully, they gain me. Those who take to karma yoga with that purified mind, finally gain the knowledge, they know me. Now you say, there are people who can't take any of these. They are not capable that. Then what is that? They have got Shraddha in their Atmahatma, who is a Jnani. And Jnani says, look here, my dear, don't bother about it. You do this, 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 this. With full Shraddha, what they do, not any Tom, Dick, Harry. Told by Jnani who knows Shastra. Do you do only these things? They also cross over the samsara, saga, because they are put on the right track. They did not bother about the yoga, etc. This is all who say that. 14th chapter, verse 20. Gunan atitya janma mrutya jara dukkai vimuktaha amritam ashwati. Having transcended means having got rid of the identification with the embodiment made up of gunas and the free from the jagat. What they, these jnanis, what they, amritam ashwati. What moksha again? How? Janma mrutyu jara dukkai. Freed from janma mrutyu jara dukkai. That is, Bhagavan is very clear or not. In spite of this, there are Mahabhagas, they bring their own commentary, not Bhashyakara. What is that? It is a style of adhyaropapavada. In Bhagavad Gita, such many adhyaropas are done only to do apavada afterwards. Means, you need not take these statements of Bhagavad Gita seriously, though told by who? Krishna. There is a method in there, adhyaropa. They say, what do they say? Sampradaya vidam pravachanam. Those sampradaya. What is that? Adhyaropapavadadhyam nishprapancham prapanchate prapanchate. Adhyaropa, superimposition, apavada, negation, nishprapancha, Brahma free from prapancha is elaborated. So therefore, all these are what? Adhyaropa. If Bhagavan has done what? Apavada. Now tell me, what is your problem? Sorrow is your problem or not? Janma varna is your problem or not? Yes. Now tell me, is it real? If real, you cannot know anything whatsoever. If they are not there, should you bother? No, they are not there. They are truly not there, but we suffer. We are suffering not real samsara. We are suffering not non-existent samsara. We are suffering mithya samsara. From mithya samsara, mithya release, liberation should be there or not? The method adhyaropa pavada. You can't say you can take that pavada sources. And they say what? Look here. This prapancho pashava, or elsewhere it is said, prapancha pravilapana, ending of prapancha is not possible at all. Ending of prapancha is not possible. My dear sir, which prapancha you are talking of? How many prapanchas are there? I will change the word, okay? How many srishtis are there? Now you will come to the line. Two. Ishara srishti, jiva srishti. If you say prapancha pravilapana means Ishara srishti, cannot think, yes, we are not Ishara, only Ishara will do. And in that, the seed of that prapancha will be there only. That's it. We are not aware. We are talking of jiva srishti. So here, it is not destruction of the prapancha. Here, prapancha pravilapana means put out of the range of your cognition the drishya prapancha. Presently, how prapancha is presented to you? Through experience. It is within the ambit, range of your experience, is it not? Put it out of it. Can be done or not? Where? Nirvikalpa Samadhi. My dear sir, we have seen at length that you are able to experience your Atma Swarupa free from prapancha. Doesn't mean prapancha is not there. As far as your cognition is concerned, you are experiencing how? Free from that. That gives you the inkling, this is my Swarupa, and that is enough. If that is not there, what is called? It is called Shodhita Tvampada. Shodhita Tvampada really doesn't mean, we do say, Shodhita Tvampada means Nirupadhika Atma. But don't take the word Nirupadhika Atma literally, because Nirupadhika Atma we cannot know at all. Why? For us, the link is, see, link between Nirupadhika, that is Upadhi Rahita Atma, and we is what? Chidabhasa. What is Chidabhasa? Reflected Chaitanya in the Antakarana. So therefore, when we say Nirupadhika Atma means the experience of Nirupadhika Atma in the Antakarana in terms of Pratibimba. And this Pratibimba, without the, like mirror, Pratibimba reflecting not possible. Without the Antakarana, it is just not possible. To understand what you mean by Shodhita Tvampada. What is meant by Prapancha Pravilapada? So that is the, we are concerned with the reflection of Atma in its real nature, which is possible only in Nirvikalpa Samadhi. That is what Bhashyakar also said, that Swapratishtha Atma Jnayate, in that satya of Nirvikalpa Samadhi, he said. So therefore say, so that being the case, apavada means putting out of range of your cognition, wherein Atma is so reflected in its true Swarupa, for that these upadhis are necessary. Otherwise what will happen? Link between this body and the individual will be snapped off. Then what? Celebrate. If he is a bhagwa kapada dhari, if you are sannyasi. Sannyasi, if you leave the body, you are supposed to what? Celebrate, not more. Not more. I think there is some religion, I don't somewhere heard. When the child is born, they weep, and when a person dies, they laugh. Supposed to. Supposed to. I don't know, it is true or not. So that is that. So therefore, see, we can't say, my dear sir, our problem is, other things, you know, prapancha pravilapana means straight away they jump to mithyanishtaya. Yes, prapancha is mithya, but how did you ascertain? Can you ascertain something mithya without the darshana of satya adhisthana? Can you ascertain the rope to be, the snake, mistaken snake to be mithya without the knowledge of seeing directly the rope basis? What we are talking of? Yurupadhika atma, that is what shodhitam padam is. And then Mahavakya comes, this is what is Brahma Swarupa. So therefore, we should be very careful about such these notions that are floating around. So now one, our last one, what is that? Some say, I don't know whether you have come across this word, unless you have read my Brahma Sutra book. Many have not read, I know. There is a word called Swatapramana. The joke also is there. When Shankaracharya wanted to meet Mandana Mishra, he didn't know his house. So he happened even the river bank where the ladies had come to the sea. He asked, where is the house of Mandana Mishra? He said, you go like him, and on the veranda there are two parrots. And what are they rattling? Sadhanas, sadhanas, sadhanas. Parrots, okay? They are parroting. You know why? Always discuss in the scholar whether Veda is Swata Pramana or Pratya Pramana is going on. And the parents have picked it up. So like this. Now this is, they make a statement. Vedanta is Swata Pramana, therefore Atmanubhava is not required. The concept of Swata Pramana itself is wrong. English they say. What is Swata Pramana? Vedanta is Swata Pramana means independent means of knowledge. Swata Pramana, they give the meaning as what? Vedanta is independent means of knowledge, and being Swata Pramana, it doesn't need the. That translation, Swata Pramana as independent mythology, has no sense. Otherwise, you have to translate Swata Pramana as self-proved Pramana or self-validated Pramana. I will explain you what it is. You heard this? Swata Pramana should be translated as self-proved Pramana or self-validated Pramana means knowledge given by that pramana need not be verified by the help of any other pramana. Knowledge gained by that pramana, which is called Swata Pramana, need not be corroborated, need not be verified by any other means of knowledge. To give an example, it is clear. What is this? Watch. How did you say this? Perceive, pratyaksha pramana. The pratyaksha pramana gave you the knowledge after experiencing this as what? This is that watch. Sure? Now, this is Swata Pramana, the sense this need not be validated by any other pramana. You need not bring anubha, that is what is that? Inference, etc. Oh, it is ticking. It is giving it time, and I think infer that because whatever gives time is a clock or a, what do you say? Therefore, you infer what it is? Watch, and therefore, what you saw by the eyes is correct. Is it required? That's all. Now, other blunder. Vedanta is Swata Pramana. Who told you only Vedanta is Swata Pramana? According to Vedanta or Vedanta Shastra, all six pramanas are Swata Pramana. You know what is, some gadbad has happened. You know what is that? These things you have to get from Vedanta Paribhasha. The book of category of Vedanta always defined, etc. And there Swatapramana is mentioned, but it is not listed. It is not put in the content. See, there is a Pramana, Anupalabdhi, last one. After Anupalabdhi, quietly what? Swatapramana and all six. Pratyaksha, Anumana, Upama, all the Shabda, both these things are what? Swatapramana means. Knowledge given by this Pramana is self-proved, self-approved, self-valid. You need not validate it by other Pramana. It has never told that it doesn't need experience. All this you should know, otherwise the people get carried away by such statements. So this, therefore, I think this much is enough to ascertain the jnana swarupa, that atma jnana, brahma jnana certainly needs atma anubhava vyasi. We started with the pramana, that is pramana or jnana sadhana is certainly the means to gain any knowledge, but nowhere in the epistemology Pramana Shastra or nowhere in Vedanta it is told that Pramana, that is of knowledge is gained by Pramana and therefore what? Anubhava is not necessary, is nowhere told. See, and they give the example of Pratyaksha. We see Pratyaksha does involve the experiences. Our samsara is experience. The remedy for experience problem must be necessarily what? Experience. Your hunger is experience or not? Then, appeasement of hunger should be experience or not? Your suffering, experience. Freedom from suffering should be experience. That's what it is. Other thing. You are hungry. Can you know it without being aware of it? Because you are so busy in your work. You are hungry, but you are not aware of it. The work is over, immediately what happened? You felt the hunger. So, wherever subjective experience is there, first experience, then knowledge. In other day we have seen yoga ashtra. Any subjective experience is any samvit. What is samvit? Antakarana vritti vichidaha. Whether right samvit or wrong samvit are experienced. Corollary of it is what? The wrong samvit has to be known by what? Right samvit has to be certainly experienced. That we have already seen. Now, actually, Atma is beyond all pramanas. In the sense, Atma is not prameya, an object to be known by any pramana, including Vedanta. Vedanta-Pramana is certainly true, but Atma is not jneya of Vedanta-Pramana. Vedanta-Pramana leads you to a certain extent wherein Pramata drops. Pramana drops, what I mean is what? Atma Swarupa. When Pramata is not a, where is the Pramana, where is the Prameya? What is it? So, it can only make end all that is not Atma and it cannot object the Atma. For this, it is said that when you say Nirupadhika Atma, or Shodhita Atma, champion one Bhashyakar also said this in the Kathopanishad. So in that Nirvikalpa Samadhi only, what we mean to say is, in that we have an experience of Atma free from Upadhi. See, that's Nirupadhika state is a state of what? Antakarana. Antakarana is Upadhi or not? Yes. But at that time it is not in full swing. It was in a dormant samskara form. That also is Upadhi. We are not concerned with it. We are concerned with our experience of Atma, reflection of Atma is true nature. That is what we can go up to. Nirupadhika Atma is beyond. See, therefore, don't fool yourself with some people. As a Puritan, you know that Nirupadhika is not possible. We know that Nirupadhika is not possible. But what do you mean? How can you then? Nirupadhika Atma is not possible. How can you give the knowledge? We gain Pratibimba of Atma free from Upadhi, which is possible where in the Nirvikalpa Samadhi. This is explained, see, really this Anubhuti Prakasha is a book which is a must for all Vedantic teachers. So many blunders are done without knowing many subtle nuances as Anubhuti Prakasha. In the Anubhuti Prakasha, 16th chapter. It's like 16th chapter. What is that? Madhuvidya Prakasha. Madhuvidya Prakasha. Verse 40 says this, that Nirupadhika Atma can be known by Pratibimba of Atma. How can you see your face? Pratibimba, reflection in the mirror. Mirror is different from you. Without mirror you can't see. But is the face you are reflection your face? No. If reflection is your face, what is it? You want to put killer. Man. Mirror. Mirror is got dirty. Very good. The goal is that. Like that, what you are getting in Nirupa Nirvikalpa Samadhi is Pratibimba, reflection of Atma exactly as it is. My dear sir, real Atma is not available for any Pramana. Even if you say the word Brahma, you know, foul. Why foul? It can't apply to Brahma. Why? Brahma is a word being relative to Swa. In Brahma, neither big is there nor small. Then entire Vedanta Shastra speaks of Brahma. This is a method coined by, you know who? Jivan Muktas, who know Nishprapancha Brahma. At the same time, they have got the idea about the prapancha. So therefore, they try to convey, not really convey. They try to convey what is the Brahma Swarupa by making use of what is available in the world. So that is what should know the methodology of it, that really Brahma word also is not applicable to Brahma. Atma word also is not. That it is said in Madhuvidya Prakasha. Even Chaitanya or none of these words, Atma, etc., cannot be applicable. Chaitanya Atma Adayaha Shabdaha Vyutpannaha Pratibimbake. They are Vyutpanna. Vyutpanna means have originated from Pratibimba or proficient in communicating by Shaktyartha. Main meaning, prominent meaning, in terms of Pratibimba only. When you say Atma, when you say Brahma, actually it applies to exact reflection of Atma, Brahma in the Nirvikalpa, Antakkarna. Nirvikalpa, Antakkarna. Not, and from there what you say? You infer, oh, this is my Swarupa. How do you say so? Pramana. What is Pramana? Other day I was saying, in Nirvikalpa Samadhi, we have the experience of our Swarupa, Atma Swarupa, Brahma Swarupa as it is. If Vedanta were not to point out, and a person is accomplished by Ashtanga Yoga, the Nirvikalpa Samadhi, will he ever know that it is his Swarupa? This is where Pramana comes. Just don't say Pramana and therefore no Anubhava requirement, right? Not possible. Whole life he may be in the Nirvikalpa, not Nirvikalpa. Repeatedly, maybe in the Nirvikalpa Samadhi, you will not know. So that's why. But only because you read your Shastra and practice Shastra and Paparat Shastra, you are not known it unless the direct experience is there. We have seen the example of our Arctic region. Crystal garland. We have seen that. At least for a while, be aware of that. You know this is your Swarupa and how Jagat is. So that is how Chaitanyadayaha Shabdaha. Shabdaha Pratibimbake Vyutpannaha. They have originated from Pratibimba of Atma. They are applicable to Pratibimba of Atma, not to the Nirguna Atma at all. Chidatmanam Lakshayanti. They indicate the Chaitanya Swarupa Atma. Tena Yathatmya Yathatma Vedanam. By the means of that Chit Pratibimba, you can know what is the Atma Swarupa. So therefore, without the experience of this Pratibimba, Atma is true nature, Nirvikalpavadi, Atmajnana is not possible. If you are allergic to the word Anubhava, I have already given substitute. What is it? Aware of. Be aware of your Swarupa free from this, and that being aware of itself is what? Experience Anubhava. Without being aware of, you cannot know you are free from all this. Without being aware of, you are hungry, you can't know that you are hungry. So that is there. So that, therefore, so that is, it is the Pratibimba of Atma in this Nirvikalpa Samadhi, that is what we know. And in this Kathopanishad we have seen Bhashya 2, 3, 9, 10, 11, Bhashya tells that Nirvikalpa Samadhi, free from Laya, Vikshepa, Kashaya. Kashaya means defects which make you extrovert. That is Bahirmukha Sauskar and Rasaswada. Only that Swarupa Pratishtaha Atma Jnayate. These are the words of Bhashyaka. Only in this way. That's what why? Atma Pratibimba is exactly available there only. And mithya nishchaya, without that, mithya nishchaya cannot be done. Without the adhishthana darshana, satya adhishthana darshana, mithyatva jagat cannot be done at all. It is not that. If done, it is only, that is what is called as this. Just borrowing the words from the Shastra. Borrowing the words from the Shastra. This way already, other day still. That is that. Samvit. What is Samvit? Now also we have seen. Antakarana vritti plus pratibimbita chaitanya. Any Samvit is experiential. We can change it like this. Any subjective thing is experiential or not. But what you experience can be right or wrong. Just as you saw the silver, subjectively experienced or not?
Yes.
But actually it was shell. Right experience or wrong experience? Right samvit or wrong samvit? Wrong samvit. Then you went close and this you want? Self. This is right samvit or wrong samvit?
Right
samvit. So therefore, to remove that wrong samvit, what is necessary is right samvit. I am a sukha dukkha atmaka samsari. Right samvit or wrong samvit? My dear sir, how do you experience that you are samsari? I am talking to Indian audience, okay? On YouTube, some other should be samsara. What is that? Our sukha dukkha, sorrowful, happy existence. Are you not experiencing that? How? In terms of antakarana vritti. See, you tell me, in making state, samsara is there or not? Look here, don't mistake samsara means having wife, husband, children, all that is not. Sukha, dukkha, sukha, dukkha, sukha, dukkha, that way, movement by movement, we experience the what? Limitation, try samsara. In making samsara is experienced or not? In dream, samsara is experienced or not? In sleep, experience? Doubtful? No! But, cause is there. But what is there? Cause is there. Now, what samsara experience the waking, is it not through the channel of antakarana vrittis? What samsara experience in the dream, is it not through the channel of antakarana vrittis? In sleep, no antakarana vrittis, no samsara. Therefore, now, antakarana vrittis are subjectively experienced or not? Are they samvit or not? So we are, I am samsari samvit. Equally, I should experience, I am free from samsara, then only it can be. This is the corollary of what Yoga Vasishtha says. One more thing. See, this is what they say. Do you know from where they started? What is that? See, prapanchopashamam shantam shivam advaitam chaturtham advaitam chaturtham mandyante sa atma sa vidneya. Once upon a time, this is where from it triggered off, okay? You say that chaturtham mandyante, that is atma swarupa, that is Turiya. And this Turiya, Atma Swarupa, is fourth pada. In the sense, not a distinct from the earlier three padas. Vishwa, Taijasa, Prajna, and Chaturtha, Turiya. Okay. It is in and through all these things, and you see, but Turiya is not available for experience. Started from there on. Why? Now tell me, sir. Vishwa, first father, weaker consciousness, available by experience or not?
Yes.
Still not. Waking state is experiential or not?
Yes.
Experiential.
Yes.
Movement by movement are experiencing. Fine. What is called Vaishpradnya? Vaishpradnya. Then, dream state, antapradnya, available for experience or not?
Yes.
Yes. Then, the ghanapradnya, deeply state, experiential or not?
Yes.
Yes, afterwards we come to. Now, tell me, these many pradnyas are told, no? Belonging to waking, dream and deep state. All these pradnyas are experienced because of what? They are inner vrittis. Because of Atma, and with that Atma, free Atma. And do you mean to say when they are not there, the Atma which enables the experience, which is the Anubhava Swarupa, stops?
No.
It will be as foolish like, you know, what is that? See, look. It is all cloudy outside now. Overcast is there. But what is the time?
Six.
Sun is not set yet. That example should be fell, no. fell, will you go out? Are you able to see the clouds or not? If it were pitch, Amavasya, new moon night, would you have been able to see? No. Now you could see because what is the backdrop? Who is there? Sun is there. And you, oh, sun is there. Now let us say at that time, all cloud dispersed. Sun is seen or not? This Kriyatma is not ever experienced like this. When the clouds are there, sun is seen. When clouds are dispersed, sun cannot be seen. Parallel. Waking Vishwa, dreamer Taijasa, sleeper Pranya, and all that is experienced. He is experienced because of what? Chaitanya Swarupa Atma means this is Anubhava Swarupa. These are inner Drishya or not? Drishya is remote. What remains? Chaitanya Swarupa. How do you say? Other way we are saying, don't bring Anubhava experience means Triputis. We go that way only. We are saying without Triputis, Anubhava is in detail. We have seen all these things. So, without. In sleep, no Triputi, experience is there. In Nirvika Samadhi, no Triputi, experience is there. Not there. Here, we are talking of experience Swarupa Atma, which enables the Triputi experiences. Because they are inert. Antakarana, vritti. Therefore, it is. So that being the case, keep this phrase in mind. You know what is that? We already seen in detail. Nahi drishtuhu drishtehe viparilopaha vidyate by avinashitva. Radharaneka 4, 3, 23 to 30. Chaitanya swarupa atma, it only means this much. Chaitanya swarupa atma is never extinct. For which we have seen another word, what is that? Vipaschit from Patomishad. What is the meaning? A viparilupta chaitanya svabhava. This is what aviparilupta chaitanya svabhava means. Chaitanya, nature of chaitanya, which is never extinct. When chaitanya, which enables all experience of samsara, when adhyasa is eliminated, it remains. How can that experience stop? It cannot, it has to continue. And that is why Bhashyakara at the top of his voice shouts. I am getting shouts. He says, he doesn't shout. What he says? In gaining jnana aham brahmasmi, all that you have to do is eliminate the adhyasta. Adhyaropita nirakaranam eva kartavya. 18th chapter Bhagavad Gita Bhashya, wherein it is what the samsiddhi, that capacity to gain jnanishta, Bhagavan has said there in that Bhashya. Bhashyakara repeatedly says, adhyaropa nirakaranam eva kartam. To gain knowledge, you have to get freed from all adhyastha things. And it is possible where? Only in the nirvikatva. In your cognition, okay? Not from the world standpoint. In your cognition. That is your swarupa. So therefore, and this being so, I don't understand how it is said, what is that? Atmajnana, Brahmajnana doesn't need Atma without analyzing. I don't know whether it is an attempt to psychotherapize Vedanta. Understood? I will explain, okay? I-Z-E suffix means eyes. Psychotherapy plus IZ is suffix, psychotherapy means, IZD means make. IZD means what? The suffix means what? Make. I don't know whether they are psychotherapizing Vedanta means they are making Vedanta psychotherapy. If they are attempting, I would advise. What is that? If possible, Vedanta is the psychotherapy. Understood? Vedanta is the psychotherapy. Make psychotherapy Vedanta if it is possible. Who is benefited? Patient will be benefited if they are available. By trying this psychotherapy as a Vedanta, neither you are helping Vedanta nor you are helping psychotherapy. You know this, I mean, so, you heard this word, realize the interest. What is meant, realize that? Make the interest real. The interest was on the paper. So either you get it credited in your account or get the cash in your hand. Realize the self, no? Self-realization. After TI1, there is a non-believer. Realize the self is what? Self-I, which Shastra says, free from samsara. Make it real means what? You discover that you are free from samsara. Self-realization means what? Making the Atma, self, real in its true nature, free from samsara. That is how it is. So therefore, so if at all attempt is there to do this, it should be to Vedantize the psychotherapy and not psychotherapize Vedanta. What I have told so far in these, how many talks do you know? From Mandukya 45th talk to 58th today talk, 14th talk, whatever I have told, I have given you Shastra Pramana. If at all there is any Pramana which supersedes what I have told, please bring it to my notice. And what? You can make note of this. You can inform this on the email ID sssbvt@gmail.com. 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 You can listen here. But Shastra Pramana, no hearsay, no arbitrary translation. So I would like to scrutinize that. And if you want, on my website, there is one interesting article. Many good articles are there. In this context, I say one article. Is desire desirable? Name itself, the title is interesting. Is desire desirable? In that, in one context, I have given in detail the modus operandi of gaining Atmajnana, Brahmajnana. With great detail I have gone through it. I have taken it here, but in that article also there. That is available on website Rubhu Vasishtha. Rubhuvasishtha @wordpress.com. wordpress.com. You get it? And many other interesting articles also you can make use of that. So that is the case. I think with this we can now proceed with our Mandukya Mantra 7 Bhashya. I would, if you can spare some time, I would recommend that you revise on YouTube or Facebook the teaching of the talks, Manduka talks, 45 to 58. First, know what you are in for. What is the point in beating around the bush? You may lack in many preparations, eligibility. You can pray also, you can make good of them, etc. But what is expected, first be very clear. You can do. We are trying for your convenience to separate these talks, 45 to 58, with an introductory small video and upload as a separate set of videos giving a title, Atmajnana, Its Nature. We'll remove all these prayers, etc., so that your time will be saved. You can straight away listen also, or that, but that will take some time. So we'll upload as a separate, that is what topic, Atmajnana, Its Nature. All this will be there at one place, as that. So make proper use of this. I think let us conclude today.